How to sound your best on Zoom. This tutorial will take you from sounding like
this through to sounding like
this. And we'll also have a little bit of
this plus a touch of this.
And then finally, we're going to have a bit of fun by looking at a little bit of
this. I'm Simon, and this is computer tutoring. Oh, come on, get started already.
Great. Okay, so you're in a Zoom meeting and you want to sound your best. So this video is all about sound. It's all about how to sound your best. If you want to know how to look your best, then please click on the link. I don't know where it's going to be here. So it might be that you've spent all that time and effort into looking your best, but it can all go to waste if you don't sound great. So just like the look good video, look your best video on Zoom, we're going to start off with the worst sound possible, and then we are going to build up from there. If you haven't already done so, make sure you click on that subscribe button, click on that notifications button so you don't miss a thing. This is the second in a series of three tutorial videos. The first, how to look your best on Zoom. The second is how to sound your best on Zoom. And the third is how to make sure your Wi-Fi is the best for Zoom. Let's start off with the worst sound in Zoom. So I'm just going to record a Zoom session and then we're going to go to our worst sound in Zoom. Here we go. Okay, so.
Okay, so now I'm in Zoom and I've started a Zoom meeting and I'm using what we could probably agree is one of the worst sounds. And that is the sound that comes from your laptop. The microphone doesn't sound that good. In fact, it's picking up the fan. It's trying to pick up all of the ambient noise. It just seems to pick everything up. It's just not great. If you are in this stage, what can you do to sort of like help the situation? So we're going to go ahead and we're going to use what a lot of other people use. And that is a set of earphones.
Okay, I'm now on Zoom and I'm recording this with my earphones with the microphone that's built in. Got to be careful about, you know, banging it against your side here. Sometimes it can be difficult to know whether your headphones can be used as a microphone. So a couple of clues would be, have just a little look along and see if literally it does have a microphone on it. If you're still in doubt, so maybe you've got like a set of headphones like this with a wire and you're not sure whether it includes it, just have a look here and see if you can see the difference. You see the one has got three sections and the other has two sections. So the one with three sections includes the microphone. So just have a quick look at the end of your wires if you're unsure. If you do have three, great, you're ready to go and you're ready to sound a lot better. So some people might think, you know, I've spent all that money on Bluetooth headphones with noise cancellation and everything like that. How could that be worse than these, which are freebie ones that you get with a phone? Well, what I'm doing, I'm in Zoom. Let me just record in Zoom here. And let me just change the microphone. So I'm just going to go down to the bottom left-hand corner there. Let us just go up. And at the moment, I've got the opportunity to use my headset BX hands-free audio. So let's turn to that one. Wait for a year and a day.
And now the audio that you are hearing is through my headphones. And I think you agree that it doesn't sound that great. In fact, those headphones, they sounded much, those earphones, those freebie earphones that I had, they sound much better. So what's the point here is these headphones are meant for sound. They've got the noise cancellation and everything on them to make the sound sound good. However, these Bluetooth headphones might not incorporate a suitable microphone to help you sound your best on Zoom. So where do we go from here?
All right, so now I am using what I can safely say is my favorite microphone. It's the one I use for my training sessions, and it's got a beautiful name. It's called the Lavaliere microphone. So Lavaliere from the French word to hang around the neck. Like a pendant. I don't have to put anything in my ears or anything over my ears. If I've got a training day to conduct, I always go with this. And because it is closer, you can muck around with the settings a little bit more. So I'm just around to the bottom left-hand corner, go up to the settings and then go to advanced just over here. Yeah. So what I can do here is at the moment I've got it set at moderate, moderate and auto for the sound here. If I just go back, I don't know why, I'm going to just automatically adjust my volume. That's good. And just go back there and I can change it. So if, probably even disable this if my room is quiet. Yeah. Or I can click on this turn on original sound. This is particularly for music as well. So there's no suppression whatsoever. If you're going to use any of the microphones that plug into a laptop, so within the microphone socket, you'll come across a little problem, especially if I was, when I was using the Lavalier here, the condenser mic just here. The issue is basically is that there's only one headphone stroke microphone socket on my laptop and many are the same. It's just, I think they're trying to save space or money or something, I don't know. So what you'll need to get is something known as a splitter, okay? So just like the earphones that I showed earlier on, if I just, earphones I look at earlier on, if you look there, you can see that it's got three sections there. Plug it in, plug your headphones in one socket, and it'll be marked up with the microphone. So this one here, the pink's the microphone, and the green's the headphones, and then you'll be ready to go. So there we have it, the Lavalier microphone, the lapel microphone, my favorite. But what happens if you want to take your sound quality even further? Well, you could get one of these. So this is known as a condenser microphone. So I do need to plug this in somehow via USB port or whatever. So you can just plug this straight into your laptop, into your computer, and the sound is, you got it a lot better. I have a nice echo option as well. I can turn up so I can, gives me a little echo if I wanted to. If you wanted to sound that way, let me just turn that down again. What I'd probably do here is turn off the, so turn on the original sound here. Go to audio settings here. And then I would probably go to advanced just down here. And then I would probably just disable that sound. So let's just disable everything. There we go. I'm going to close that one down. Brilliant. So here we go. So if I'm going to use this as a voice narration, or maybe if I'm going to do a training session where people aren't really going to see my face a lot, then I've got this here. The only downside with this is it's quite big. I can really get close and personal if I want to do a DJ or if I'm going to do some sort of online dance party. You just want your microphone as close as you comfortably can have it, you know, like so. And in this way, don't talk too loud. Don't shout. I tend to maybe speak with a loud volume. You don't have to do this. It will adjust. It will pick up the volume and it will be fine. So we go to the settings and go to audio settings here. If there's like ambient noise in the room, so if I turn my telly on again, okay, and then I can just turn this to, okay, there we go. So there we go. So this, let me just, so we can see here that this is aggressive background noise suppression and aggressive intermittent background noise suppression, but I think you can hear me just as well, you know, it's great. So I would do all of that, especially if you've got some noise going on in the background there. So what happens if you want to then take this a little bit further? Yeah, maybe you're going to play some music. So what do you get? This microphone is fantastic for that. Let's have a listen, shall we, and hear how this sounds. All right, so say for instance you want to record, you've got the opportunity of doing a performance, what should you do? Let's have a quick look at the different settings which are standard. So say for instance you don't change your settings, I'm just going to go to here and just make sure all of these are auto. And then, yeah, that's good. Yeah, we go. So I'm going to grab my plectrum here. So here we go. Nice original song, London Day. Just do the chorus, shall I? London Day, dodging bodies in the rain, I'm pushing past the pigeons on the street, oh, I'm looking for a place to eat. Warm me. Okay, so there we go. Let us turn on the original sound here. Let's go back onto our sound settings and let us disable all of this. Get rid of this because your mic should be good enough for that.
That's great. Now, if you don't see original sound here, just make sure that this checkbox here is checked, and then you'll see original sound there. Let's give that one a go again. Please forgive my singing there, but here we go.
Run away. It's soon better to be safe than sorry.
Doing a high bit, right? So
8 o'clock and I'm feeling rotten, about to start another day. The tea is cold and the milk is off, and it seems I'll be late to work again.
Now you want to do some music and you want to take it the next bit further. Other than using the condenser microphone, you could get yourself one of these. It's an audio USB interface, so basically it plugs in via USB into your computer. This one here is just known as the Euphoria UMC204HD, and you can see I've got two inputs there, if I can get my hand round here. Oops, wrong side. So this one here is an XLR microphone, so that plugs into this lovely Shure 50 SM58 microphone. Had that for years and it's still really good. And then this one here plugs into my guitar, and then this one just here is for my headphones, so I can monitor and listen, because I've got two sound levels here. So I just want to make sure that I'm not going to, you know, be singing really loud and my guitar is going to be going over the top of it. So then I can adjust my sound levels. Okay. Brilliant. Excellent. Okay. So let's just try one.
London Day. I'm dodging rallies in the rain. I'm pushing past the pigeons on the street. Ooh, I'm looking for a place to eat.
So let's try it again. What I want to do is make sure I turn on original sound. Let's go to the audio. Let's go to advanced, just down here. And you see these are all disabled. I don't want any of these on, and the echo cancellation just on auto. That's really good. So whenever you're doing that, make sure when you do this, you make sure you turn on the original sound. So this there is blue, and then you're ready to go. Brilliant. Let's try this one here then.
Talking away, I don't know who see you. Sit anyway. Today's another day just to find me. Shine away. I'll be coming for you. I'm okay.
Okay then, so say for instance you want to add some funny voices to when you're on Zoom so that you sound like somebody else. What you can do is you can use a free program called Voice Mod. I'll give you the link down below. And then what that basically does is it runs in your system tray. I'll give you a voice mod, so that's how it looks here. When you open it up, it gives you free voices that change every day. And it runs like a little microphone. I can hear my own voice there. Now, I always find that this runs better with headphones, because if there's speakers and it picks it up here, you get a lot of feedback and the noise cancellation can really make it rubbish. So what I'm going to do here is this drop down list here and make sure I choose my voice mod virtual audio.
And now whatever voice I choose on this here, it will be. So this will be hello. So I should be sounding like a little baby. So that's how I should be sounding. Just like a little baby. if I want to, I can.
Of course. The options here, let me just minimize that. And some of these as well have ambient effects as well, which come in the background, so you can put on ambient effects if you need to.
Echo.
Once you've got used to your voice, I would turn off hear my voice, so you don't have to hear it, but other people do have to hear it as well.
There's nothing to worry about. I've taken care of everything.
So you might want to muck around with that a little bit and see what settings are a little better for the voice mod. Great, excellent. So if you've got anything out of this, please give us a thumbs up. It'd be really appreciated. If you've not yet done so, click on the subscribe and then the notifications button so you don't miss the next tutorial about the Wi-Fi, trying to make sure that your Wi-Fi is the best. We at Computer Tutoring cover a wide range of subjects, so please check out our website. If you're an Instagrammer or a Twitterer, check us out, please. We'd love to hear from you.
If there's any other suggestions or hints or tips that you use when you're using Zoom, and especially in relation to sound, then leave them in the comments below. We'd really like to hear from you. Just hope everyone's okay. Just want to say thank you so much for watching.